kids, the first section of the Bible is about the law. You remember from the last video, and the first book of the Bible is Genesis, where it teaches us how God created everything. He created the rivers, the seas, nature all around us, and that's where I am right now. I'm camping in the middle of nature. It's also about how life was before and after sin. So when God created man and woman, God had to be separated from man and woman because of the consequences of sin. Now, the next books of the Bible are Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. Those books are all part of the law with Genesis. In these books, we learn all about a people who God created to be separated from all the other people and to be holy before Him. Okay, and these people were called the people of Israel. In Leviticus chapter 20 and verse 26, we read, "You are to be holy to me, because I, the Lord, am holy, and I have set you apart from the nations to be my own." And what holy means, guys, is to basically be perfect and have nothing wrong in you at all. And there's only one person who was holy on this earth, and that was the Lord Jesus. But the Bible teaches us that that is how God wants us to be. It's pretty hard, but that is where we should be aiming for if we trust in the Lord Jesus as our Savior. And it was very hard for the people of Israel to be like this. But the Bible teaches us that because they belonged to God, they had to follow the rules, the law of God. And so in the books of the Bible, the first books of the Bible, Genesis, Leviticus, Exodus, Deuteronomy and Numbers, those books are all about the law and the beginning of the life of the people of Israel. So how can I put it into perspective into our lives today here on this earth, guys? So at home, your parents tell you the rules of the house, okay, and what you should be doing. So if you have to make your bed in the morning or go to sleep at night by a certain time, that is the law of your house. The law of the Bible, when you trust in the Lord Jesus as your Savior, is a little bit different, because from that point onwards, your whole body, your whole life should be in accordance to how God wants you to live. And what God wants you to do is to be holy and to always strive to do the best possible and to serve Him. So in other words, to think about others and not of yourself, to respect and to honor your parents, to try and tell other people about the Lord Jesus, and to live out your whole life for Him. That is what God wants from you when you trust in Him as your Savior. That is the law in your life. Now, kids, the history books, which are as follows: Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1 Samuel, 2 Samuel, 1 Kings, 2 Kings, where we've been reading about Elijah and Elisha, 1 Chronicles, 2 Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, and Esther. That's a lot of books, isn't it? Well, all those books form the history part of the Bible. Now, later on, we're going to hear a song and we're going to sing all the books of the Bible, okay? Now, some people I know memorize the Bible through singing this song, and then you can memorize all the books of the Bible in the head, all 66 books, imagine that. But I'm not expecting you to do it on the first go. But yeah, if you can sing the song later on, you'll be able to learn the books of the Bible. Anyway, kids, these books are the historical books of the Bible. Now, when I was a kid, I think that when I was reading the Bible, around your age maybe, these books were my favourite parts of the Bible. And I'll explain why. I like adventure stories. I used to love reading books like The Famous Five and reading adventure stories about children going camping or doing adventures and things like that. And the people of Israel, when they left Egypt, when Moses went and he took them out of Egypt, it's an adventure. They're going out into the desert, they're going into the wilderness, into the unknown, and they're facing different enemies and they're facing things on their own as an adventure. And I think that's why I really enjoyed it. But you know, the historical books of the Bible are important so that we can learn about the lessons that the people of Israel had to learn. And we can also find out about the mistakes that they made and how they had to overcome them with God's mercy and His grace towards them. Now, it's also important to remember how loving God was towards the people of Israel and how He forgave them time and time again when they made mistakes. And it's in these books, guys, in the historical books and also later on in the poetical books, that we read about David, Solomon, Elijah and Elisha. These are the books that we've been most concentrating on in the last few months since lockdown, kids. After history books, there comes the poetry books, and I'm going to explain them both now because the video is going to get too long otherwise. But yeah, the history books, and after that comes the poetry books, and those are Job, Psalms, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes and Songs of Solomon. Now, Job is an example of a really wise man, and his story is fascinating about how he went through a tremendous amount of pain and suffering, but he came out of it And God blessed him because of it, because God blesses those who trust and have faith in him. Now, after that, there comes Psalms and Proverbs. The Psalms were written by David, and the Bible tells us that he was a man close to God's heart in 1 Samuel chapter 13 and Acts chapter 13, you'll read about that. And yeah, you already know a little bit about David's life, but you can imagine some of the wonderful poetry that David wrote. And actually, kids, you will be able to learn at when you get to a certain age about poetry at school, but if you read the Bible, you'll see what some of the most amazing poetry that man has ever written. And Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, and Songs of Solomon were written by none other but Solomon himself, who, as you guys know, was a very wise man. And the Bible even teaches us that there was no other man who was as wise as Solomon was. And why was he so wise, kids? Because God blessed him with wisdom. When God gave him the choice as to what, he could choose anything that he ever wanted to be blessed with. And Solomon chose wisdom. And God shows his wisdom in the city of Jerusalem and through Solomon's reign in the kingdom of Israel. So that's it, kids. Those are the books on history and on poetry. Now on to the books of the major and the minor prophets.
Hi, kids. Great to be back for Explorers. Just a little word about some of the ways that the Bible is different to any other book that's ever been written. We have the prophetical books, the books of prophecy, and they're wonderful because they're different from the history books. In the history books, they look back and tell us how God helped and blessed and kept his people in the past. The prophecy books, they look forward to the future, and so they tell us that God will bless and keep and protect. His purposes will always be accomplished. And so we read in the books of the major prophets, that is a title that Bible students have given to the first five prophetical books in the Old Testament: Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, and Daniel. People call them the major prophets. But you need to remember this, that that's not what God calls them. As far as God is concerned, they're all prophets, so none are more important than the others. So, for example, Obadiah is a minor prophet, but that's only because his book is one chapter in the Old Testament, but he's just as important as Isaiah. You see, the major prophets, they bring before us wonderful teaching about God's Son, who is foretold, who is talked about in his wonderful life. And so if you read the prophecies of Isaiah and Jeremiah, you get detailed prophecies, verses that point forward hundreds of years to God's Son, who would come, where he would be born, how he would be born, how he would live, how he would die, how he would rise victorious from the dead. And then when you come to the books of Hosea and Joel and Obadiah and Amos, you're into the minor prophets. Not that God thinks that they're minor. They're just as important as the major prophets. That is why I prefer not to talk about major and minor prophets, because they're all major prophets. They were all faithful to God. And so, for example, a book that is called Hosea, God asks him to do something amazing. He asks him to marry a woman who is called a prostitute to teach God's people a lesson. And so the way she behaved was like the way that God's people were behaving as they drifted away from God, and God wanted them back, because God always wants us near to him. And then in the book that followed, in Joel, God tells us that there is going to be judgment, but there's going to be blessing. And some of those things that he writes about 400 years before they took place actually happened, which shows you can trust your Bible. You can read about a man like Jonah, and God wanted him to take a message to a huge city called Nineveh, the capital of the Assyrian kingdom, and Jonah didn't want to go. He wanted to go to another place. He got on a boat, he paid his passage, and he went to a place in northern Spain. But of course, he learned a lesson that we've all had to learn. God's will is always the best. And he eventually arrived in the city of Nineveh, and he began to preach. And would you believe it, boys and girls, 120,000 people were saved. And God blessed the preaching of this man. So do read your Bible. every single day. Read through these prophets and you're looking into the future, and you'll discover this, that God has a wonderful future for his people. Amen.
Well, kids, I really hope that you enjoyed that video and that you enjoyed all the explanations about the Bible. I know that there's a lot to take in there about the Old Testament, but we're now going to sing a brand new song, sung for you guys especially, all the way in Brazil by my mum and my brother, and I hope you guys really enjoy it. You're going to see in the song that they've all got different colours, okay? All the books are in different sections of colours. That's because it's the law, the history, the poetry, the major and the minor prophets, and then the New Testament, which we're going to learn all about in a couple of weeks' time, kids. So enjoy the song.
Deuteronomy, Joshua, Judges, Ruth and Samuel.
Samuel, Kings, Kings, Chronicles and Chronicles.
Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther, Job, Psalms, Proverbs.
Ecclesiastes, Song of Solomon, Isaiah, Jeremiah.
Lamentations, Ezekiel, Daniel, Hosea, Joel, Amos.
Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk.
Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi. The grand old book. You'll find the words of comfort wherever you may look.
In sorrow or in pain,
his promises are plain. So keep on believing in the grand old book. Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, Thessalonians.
Thessalonians, Timothy, Timothy, Titus, Philemon, Hebrews.
James, Peter, Peter, John, 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 Jude, Revelation.
The grand old book.
The grand old book. You'll find the words of comfort wherever you may look.
In sorrow or in pain,
his promises are plain. So keep on believing in the grand old.
So keep on believing in the grand old book.